summer is coming, and once again, many people try to cool their entire house.
But what about the so-called energy poor or the elderly people? They will suffer in silence and be too tired to do anything.
Indeed, for them, but also for you. If you want to save on costs, let me show a smarter way. Just cool yourself. It's cheaper, it's quicker, and much more sustainable. I think it's the easiest DIY solution that I ever presented in one of my videos. Everyone can do this. Hi, Norbert here. I'm an energy engineer. In this video number 104, I explain how to cool yourself if your budget is low, the airco installer busy for the next 7 weeks, or still nobler. You are worried about all the 365,000 air conditioners that are installed worldwide each day in this month before summer. Its average consumption of all these air conditioners during a warm day, well, you see it, and it is equal to one big new power plant built and running each week for these new air conditioners alone. Put this in contrast with a frozen bottle. Place it in front of a fan and let the cool air refresh your skin. I'll show you a simple trick to make the airflow even better. And for the volunteers, you can recover the heat of the freezer.
What's that?
Did you know that your freezer actually throws away heat all the day? If you could recover that heat, you could preheat your domestic hot water. Even if I haven't built it yet, the concept is simple and sound.
Well, that becomes complicated. You're losing the simplicity impact of this video, Norbert.
Exactly, Sam. Let's leave this for another day. But just let me calculate how much energy is in 10 frozen bottles per day to compare it with the consumption of an air conditioner. Well, it's about 3 kilowatt hours per day for 10 frozen bottles of 1.5 liter.
Oops, that is also quite some energy. The air conditioner can run 3 hours nonstop with that.
Right, Sam. Anyway, frozen bottles is still less energy than cooling a whole house. And the big advantage is that everyone can start with it already today, with their own refrigerator or the freezer and the fan that everybody has. From the other side, this 3 kilowatt hour in bottle makes heat recovery from the freezer sound a little bit more interesting, right? My first guess would be 4 kilowatt hour, in theory, a bit more than the cold.
You make an important point, Norbert. If it is so easy to have personal cooling with just your freezer, this summer, millions of elderly people and also 10% of all households that are energy poor even in developing countries, they will suffer from the heat in silence. They can't afford air conditioning. Some don't even open their windows at night, out of fear. But beyond a certain temperature, you are not able to sleep, to do your daily activities, even to be nice with the others in house. It's about dignity. Sometimes even about survival.
And you can save the food in the fridge in case of a blackout. Use the frozen bottles as coal batteries. Let's think of the countries with a weak grid.
Right, people not willing to discard food that suffered in a warm fridge, they decide just to eat it, and that's another health risk. Another situation where dignity is at stake.
Okay, also the frozen bottles need quite some energy. Let me therefore quickly explain how heat recovery may offset this cost, and then we go quickly to the question, how to use the frozen bottles. This part of the spiral, right after the compressor, is where the refrigerant is still very hot. That's a perfect place to press a copper pipe fixed to a metal plate with thermal paste in between. So no drilling or soldering the high pressure ducts of the freezer.
Oh, I am so glad with that one.
Through this coil, water at 17 degrees Celsius from your tap water supply flows slowly to your boiler. So what happens? The freezer gives off its waste heat to this water. It is cooled and thus doesn't need to work so hard anymore.
So the frozen bottles will need less than 3 kilowatt hours per day.
Exactly. And also your domestic hot water storage will get water of maybe 25 degrees Celsius instead of 17 degrees and work less. You save therefore in two ways.
But you need an intermediate water storage because the DHW tank lets flow the cold water only when you consume hot water. The freezer dumps heat all the time. They're not synchronized.
Hey, give me a break. You too. I am looking in the YouTube servers. I see that watchers are leaving the video already.
Okay. Then let's do it simple. Just dump the recovered heat in a low-cost and low-pressure 10-liter bottle and install a tap on it so that you can wash your hands with lukewarm water during the whole day.
Okay, that's a good idea. Cold water is bad for rheumatic hands, especially for the older folks. Anyway, I like drinking cold water. If you two are done with these frozen bottles and they are molten, I can help you to consume it before it is at 25 degrees Celsius again. That's also a form of personal cooling.
Brilliant, Grace. It is central cooling, with your stomach taking the role of the chiller room. I'll join you.
You both are smart, but don't drink the water too cold in the summer. Now let's see how to use these cold bottles. That will certainly interest now the watchers.
Yes, but let's first ask support for the channel. Heatwave started early this year, also in the USA. In the rest of the world, Asia is even hit harder than Europe. It is easy to imagine that the households with the least financial means, but also the elderly, have often the hottest home.
Right, but a fridge and a freezer is in many more homes than air conditioners, and this solution is really quick to organize. That's good news. So if you like the video until now, please put your thumbnails up into the air and subscribe to the channel. The info of today is not only for a few nerds, but can improve many lives. You can, for example, check if your own mother and father are doing well and tell about this simple trick. And share it with your neighbors, friends, and colleagues if you see they are not happy to turn to their home at the end of the business day.
Thank you, Grace and Sam. Yes, we have here in Tuscany also only one fixed heat pump in-house. And when I am working in the other room, temperatures can go up beyond 28 degrees Celsius. This new solution is practical to apply in every room you want.
Now tell us about the fans.
Again, the logic is this. Why cool the room when you only live in your skin? I told it already in this video of 2 years ago. A fan is really a very modest consumer of only 20 or 30 watts. More power is not necessary and even uncomfortable. Even the normal fan at the minimum speed gives noise, pain in your neck, and will move the paper on your desk. You can slow it down, as I told in these videos here. And then use them many hours with more comfort at a small distance from you, also during the night. A small distance means that you can make better use of the cold bottle. If you don't want this extra complication, then just run it at its own speed. Even then, with 1 kilowatt hour, you run 3 fans for 10 hours with the cost of maybe 30 euro cents.
That is a good start for our idea. The fan is cheap and you find them in every household. You don't even need to use a frozen bottle all the time. Only when the air of the fan becomes an annoying warm breeze, you go to the fridge and take a bottle from the freezer. And if you feel okay, you can put the bottle back into the freezer.
Or drink if it melted. How long does it take for a bottle to become all water again?
Well, let's try it. I want to see if it's better to position the bottle in front or behind the fan. Behind the fan will produce a more focused beam of air, I think.
How ensure that all the cold comes to you?
Right, let's make the cooling even more focused. You can place a fan on a table or in front if it has an own standard. In this example, I use a very practical solution of a chair. Build a small tunnel behind it with cardboard. and or an old towel or sheet. Here's how I did it. A chair with the two sides open, bottle inside, towel with cloth pegs to the fan and the chair. That way the airflow is concentrated around the bottle and hits you directly.
You see, with a bit of creativity, you can stay cool without wasting electricity. And it integrates with other uses, with the fan that you already use today, with saving food during an outage, and even with drinking water.
That's what bottom-up energy transition looks like, and you avoid the dependence on air conditioners as if it were the only solution, and fry the earth.
That's why sharing this knowledge matters. If you know someone who lives alone, or someone on a low income, please send them this video. You could make their summer easier. Or safer.
Remember also that I will soon be at your service to give you instant info about DIY energy at home. I am now trained by Norbert to become a chatbot, and that means that you can ask me very focused questions on how to solve problems at your home. Probably I will have also an index so that I can instantly tell which video you can watch at which minute. To learn more about your question. It is a very quick way of solving problems and nearly as good as talking one-to-one with an expert. And I will be available 24/7. It will probably be offered in a membership or maybe as part of a mailing list.
See you next time.
Bye, see you.
Wish you good energy. This is the fan, which you saw before. And here we have the bottle. And it goes here. And then it is really concentrated cold. Okay. Now we put the thermometer at this now. It was 26.5, as you saw before. Now let's see after a time. We will see also how much time the bottle melts and that Grace can drink it. So here the wind speed is 2 meters per second. The temperature is not so consistent on this meter and the thermometer of before. But before here it was 26.5, and so I take this one. That's delta, the difference, so that's okay. Okay, so after 10 minutes the temperature has been going down by 3 degrees. 1 hour is now over. Let's see the bottle.
I see children smiling. When I think about all of the things that you and me could be.